If you're trying to figure out a faster way to turn your regular videos into micro content videos, whether that's for Instagram, LinkedIn, or what have you, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you the new Smart Conform feature that came out in a recent update in Final Cut Pro 10. All right, so here we are in Final Cut Pro on my latest video that I just produced. And usually what I want to do is take only just like the first part, the intro, and transition this into something that I could post for like an Instagram reel. What you can do is select it in Final Cut Pro here, right click, and you want to duplicate the project as. And what that will do is open up a new space for you to do. And I'll usually just put at the beginning here, like IG or wherever I initially intend to post the video. And then what you want to do is go down here, especially if you're using one of the more recent updates for Final Cut Pro. Real quick pro tip here, make sure you save and back up your computer, your plugins, and whatever it is that you might have, because when you go through updates, sometimes it can get rid of all that stuff. But when you do the later updates, then you'll get like the vertical or the square. This one is going to be vertical. And then you can pick if you want it to be 720 by 1280. All of these are variations of a vertical video. I personally prefer to do this in a resolution similar to 4K or 2.5K simply because of compression in editing. Make sure you maintain that frame rate and then use that and click on that Smart Conform. And the Smart Conform, once I hit OK, is it's actually going to start converting this whole video from it being a regular 1920 by 1080p video size into a vertical video. All right, so now it's finished. And if I go ahead and double click on the IG version and come over here, then I will now see that it has intelligently cropped this video into a vertical frame. And when I export it, even though I'll see like the black bars on the side here, that's simply just to maintain the aspect ratio for the editing software. But what I actually have is just this true vertical video. And so I can go through and make sure, basically it tries to make sure everything is pretty much centered. But what I want to go through is usually just for the first few seconds that I want to showcase and just make sure that everything that I want to show of the lens or the whatever is in there. And something like this, like I usually will use tools to do like crop-ins and all that stuff. Well, we don't need chin autofocus, so I'm going to disable that by hitting V on my keyboard. And so now it won't actually crop in and all the rest of that. I'll use sometimes like film grades and things like that on here. And if I do have this on here, that should Smart Conform as well. But you can always double check. Just go ahead by hitting this symbol here. And then you can see like what size or frame aspect that something is comparative to the full video. So if I wanted for this shot to slide this over, then I can go over here in the inspector tool and just kind of slide this over. This is pulled from a previous video, so it's not like I can move that text, or I can move it off over to the other side just to further, you know, take that part out of the video if that makes sense. And then you can just kind of scrub through for what might make sense and make your adjustments that way comparative to the full video. And then when you're done, you can just hit this blue box and it will crop back down. So I'm okay with it at least showing the F1.4 tag portion of it, but it's already converted into a vertical format. So when I'm using the Smart Conform, one of the things I always use is keyboard shortcut. Not ones that I necessarily have to make up, but ones that I'm always going to use to cut or paste or even just duplicate things that are on the timeline if I have found a new way that I want to use that. So I went through in a previous video and I showed you some of these keyboard shortcuts that you can use and implement that are super easy to remember or at least put on a post-it note. So you can click on the video on the screen and get those keyboard shortcuts for Final Cut Pro 10.